हेलो, दिस इज स्वप्निल ममानी, हेड डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर, आर्ट्स कॉमर्स एंड साइंस महिला महाविद्यालय तासगांव। आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू ऑनलाइन लेक्चर सीरीज। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। ओपन द न्यू प्रोजेक्ट, सिलेक्ट वेब एप्लीकेशंस, ASP.NET, MT वेब एप्लीकेशंस, वेब एप्लीकेशन 13, ओके। In today's lecture, we are going to learn new controls. As per the previous lectures, click on the web application 13, select web, waveform, waveform 1, ASPX. By adding new item as a web page, this is our HTML page, this is our design page. Now we learn up to checkbox list. Now this literal control to link button controls. In today's lecture, we are going to learn about the six controls: literal, hyperlink, image, image button, calendar, and link buttons. So now take literal buttons. Literal buttons is used to run the code from HTML tag. So the main properties of literal control is a text. Put their HTML code, mark your tag, mark your start, mark your ending. In between mark your tag, type hello BC3. This is a work like HTML mark your tag. Any HTML code we can run through literal tag. Now see the output by running this application. Okay, you can see here the hello BC is coming from right side to left side, similar like HTML tags. Now you can change the direction also, direction equal to right. Default direction is right to left, but we can change this. Now we can see the output. It takes some time to run. You can see here hello BC3 is coming from left side to right side. Now remember, the literal tags has main property text. Now put this in the bold format by adding bold tag before marquee and end at end of marquee, and change direction to up. Now see the output. You can see here direction is changed left to right to down to up. Now after this control, first control your name is literal control. Now see about the hyperlink control. This is the similar to the anchor tag, which is we already learned in previous year. It works like an anchor tag hyperlink. Firstly, this is the main property of hyperlink is a text. Click here. Now firstly we have to add one page here. Right click on web application 13, add new item, waveform, add design page. This is the web page 2. Now what we have to do. When we click on the click here button, which is a hyperlink, go to this page. This jumps occurs from one page to another page by using hyperlink button. So add waveform. Navigate URL property we changed here to select waveform 2. Click here to go to page 2. Now see the output. Now click on the click here. Now check the output. This is the page 2. Now in this way we can control multiple pages by using the hyperlink controls. The main properties of the hyperlink control is text and navigate URL. Now see the third control, which is image. This control is used to insert the image on the web page. We can resize that image by using properties. Firstly, we have to add one image to our project. So select one image, logo image here. We can see in the Solution Explorer window, image is already inserted. So image control, the main property of the image control is a image URL. So change the image URL, which is inserted image logo, select. The image control look like this. We can resize the image by clicking on the corner circles. Now by running, we can see how it shows in this way. Now let us see the fourth control is image button. It is a similar to the image control. Change the logo to image control. Wrongly typed there. So image button control. What is the difference between the image and image button control? We can use the image as a button by using image button control. When we click on the image, we can go to the page, another page or another link. Most important property is a postback URL. Select the waveform 2. The image button controls has two main properties, that is one image URL and postback URL. So let us check what will happen when we click on the image button. Go to the page 2. In this way we can use the image button as a button control. When we click on the particular image, we can jump to another page or another link by using the image button. Now let us see the fifth control, calendar control. The very important control. Whenever we want to add time or date related options to our web page, we have to use the calendar control. The calendar controls look like this. So to check how to use the calendar control, now Add some text here, selected date colon. Take a label to show output of this control. Now click on this control to go to the function. Now change the label text. Label 1 dot text equal to calendar 1 dot selected date. When we select any date on the calendar, the text of label will be changed. Calendar 1 dot selected date. Now check how it will work. Go to the calendar control. Select year from this line, year or month, change. Now select date. Today's date is 5th November 2020. Now check the output, selected date 5th November 2020 with their time. This is the output of the calendar control. Now at last, from today's lecture, the last control is link button, 6th control. These all controls are very small in code to use, but very important controls to survive on web services. So this is a link button. It is a very similar to the hyperlink button, which we already learned in today's lecture. Now this important property of link button is text. Change the text here to click here, and again more important property is the postback URL. Now click to webform2.aspx. When we click on the click here, we will go to the page 2, similar like hyperlink button. Now you can check the output of this. This is page 2. This is very similar to the hyperlink button. Now in this way we learn. To get the more videos of this series, please like, share and subscribe. And please do not forget to press the bell icon to view latest videos. Thank you.